Once abundant through large portions of Indiana, the endangered timber rattlesnake is now difficult to find even by researchers determined to preserve the species. The snake, which ordinarily avoids confrontation, can live 20 years, but it is threatened by human persecution and habitat loss. A Purdue veterinarian says their extinction could unbalance Indiana ecosystems and preclude research into using venom as a treatment for diseases such as diabetes. The Indiana Department of Natural Resources is now tracking the snakes with radio transmitters surgically implanted by a Purdue University veterinarian. The data collected will enable wildlife specialists, including those in Purdue's forestry department, to better determine the snake's habitat needs and create forest management plans to benefit the species. Snakes captured in southern Indiana are placed in bags that funnel them into plastic tubes. The tubes protect surgeons from venomous bites and allow administration of gaseous anesthesia. Dr. Steve Thompson says keeping the snakes alive and pain-free during surgery is more challenging than with a mammal.
Rattlesnakes are dangerous around the mouth, and snakes in particular don't blink. We can't use a blink reflex to monitor anesthesia. We can't use jaw tone safely to monitor rattlesnakes under anesthesia. So in the majority of cases, we will either use an EKG, which would give us electrical assessment, or a Doppler, which allows us to monitor blood flow.
If the snake heart rate drops below its already slow 20 beats per minute, Thompson can reduce the anesthesia. The transmitter he inserts is about the size of a AA battery. 8 snakes will be equipped with the transmitters each of the next 3 years. Thompson said he's very careful to securely suture the incisions because the snake's slow metabolism can stretch healing for several weeks.
I do sutures internally that are long dissolvable sutures, so they're going to be there for 2 to 3 months before they completely dissolve, plenty of time. And then I do use a tissue glue adhesive to give a little bit more watertight seal because we are trying to release them in a very short period of time. We try to keep the time they're truly in captivity with us for a very short period of time.
The use of gaseous anesthesia and heating pads helps the snakes awake within 10 minutes. Typically, they spend no more than 72 hours in captivity. Thompson says the transmitters, which weigh less than 5% of the snake's weight, are designed to not impede normal snake functions, including reproduction. Midsummer implantation gives the snakes plenty of time to heal before they hibernate. Previously, post-operative snakes would remain dormant in the wild for up to 2 weeks. The use of new pain medications helps them get back up to speed almost immediately. For Purdue News Service, I'm Jim Shank.